The Negro Motorist Green Book is one, and it's the most long-lived of a whole host of African American travel guides that were published during the Jim Crow era in America. These guides were really important tools that African Americans used to travel safely and find places where they could stay, where they could sleep, where they could eat. They could help you find a doctor or a dentist or a pharmacy that would accept you, because when African Americans traveled, they found that they were excluded from most of these places.
We were looking at digitizing some of these more unique titles that are in the collection, and so I immediately thought that this would be a good candidate to get digitized. These serve as great examples of primary source material for studying the Jim Crow era, the Civil Rights Movement. It would be great to offer these to people beyond our walls, because not everybody can come to the Schomburg. And also they're kind of getting more delicate, you know, after all these years. And so we wanted to find a way to preserve them, but also make them more accessible. And by digitizing them, they're full image reproduction, color reproduction. So these are wonderful digital surrogates for the original that are made available to anyone who has access to the internet.
Victor Green was very subtle in his language, and it had to be subtle. In this time period, the only reason the Green Book survives, where so many other of the travel guides do not survive, is because Victor Green was able to get funding and support from the white community.
Ruth and the Green Book. It's a children's book that that's been out about 5 years. Well, Ruth is a 8-year-old little girl. This is in Chicago, 1952. She's traveling with her family from Chicago to Selma, Alabama to see her father's grandmother. Her father is an insurance salesman, and he'd been going down by train and by bus, but this year he brought a brand new Buick, and he wants to drive the family down. Her first time running into a situation where she cannot use the restroom. And the family had to explain this to her. Because back then, parents didn't talk about this with children. So Ruth is getting this firsthand experience on the spot. And they have to explain to her why her color is an issue. She hears the word Jim Crow for the first time. And that saddens her, as well as Brown Bear. But Eddie tells her to keep her eyes open for the SO service station. And she does. And they stop and they buy a Green Book. And after that, the trip really turns around for her and the family. Since the kids do study the Underground Railroad, which is a something that they get early and they get it often, and I think not to have this somewhere in their curriculum or in their studies, it's leaving out a big part of the American struggle and dream.
Green was an integrationist. He was an avowed integrationist. And he believed that if only people in America, if only white people could see and meet and have experiences with black people, that they would drop this Jim Crow. And he really believed that all they need to do is to see African Americans and to meet African Americans and to see that we're just like them.